Last year, Ford introduced or reintroduced their Ford Bronco. And along with that launch, they introduced the baby brother to it, the Bronco Sport. Well, here it is. This is the all-new 2021 Bronco Sport. And today we're going to find out if this really is the only Bronco that you need for everyday driving. And this also happens to be the Badlands edition. Let's get started. The Bronco Sport is based off of the same platform as the Ford Escape. However, they couldn't be any more different. Appearance-wise, of course, this is a lot more rugged. Size-wise, they're similar in size. You really have a sharp design from the front to the back. Really small overhangs for off-roading. Speaking of off-roading, you have rugged tow hooks here connected directly to the frame. And you know, the styling, it's a little retro and modern at the same time. You have the retro round headlamps, except they're LED, and these housings here, you have a horizontal LED bar, integrates nicely into the Bronco front grille. And you know what, this does have a lot of resemblance to the larger Bronco. I like this nice flat hood, although you do have a couple bumps on the side, and right on the outer edges you have some ridges there, and they look good as for styling, but they also serve a purpose when you're off-roading. It allows you to see the edges of your vehicle better, so that is another great feature for off-roading. Speaking of going off-road, this comes with standard 17-inch wheels and 27.5-inch diameter tires, and you get optional 29-inch diameter off-road tires, and this does come with off-road suspension, and that also includes 4 metal bash plates, so basically skid plates on the front, back, and underneath here. Don't mind the dirt. We were playing in the mud and the water, and I tried to do a quick wash on it before we filmed this. I didn't do a very good job, but you know what? The dirt looks good on the Bronco. This comes with the keyless lock and unlock, so just touch the door handle there. It's locked. However, it doesn't extend to the rear doors, meaning that if I grab the rear doors, I can't open it. However, if I grab the front, like that, then those rear doors open, same as lock. And you know, more and more manufacturers are extending that to the rear door, and yeah, it's just a nice little thing. And when you test a lot of cars and when you have vehicles that have that, you just kind of miss it to just grab the door handle and it opens. But we're gonna come back to check out the back seat of here, because there's a lot of cool things back here. But check out the back here, come on. We mentioned the squared off look. Check this out. It is almost a vertical here and nice short overhangs. This does have the trailer towing package, and it has a little hidden little wiring harness right beside there. You have LED taillights, but you have 2 different doors. You have a glass door here, so if we hit that, you have the rear glass popping up, and as an owner of a vehicle that has this, it is very, very handy. A lot of times you just don't need to open up that the entire hatch. You just want to open that the rear glass just to throw something in there or grab something quick and just close it and off you go. So you have that option, or you can hit the door. And for the size of tailgate, this is quite a light door here. Speaking of lights, this has some cool features. In above here, you have some pivoting LED lamps, one on each side, and there is a switch here. So we turn that on, these LEDs light up, and I try these out at nighttime. They are very, very bright, and what's nice is I can shine them directly right into the cargo area, or I can do one in the cargo area and one out here. And when you're camping or setting up, say you're going mountain biking or something like that, it's nice to have light, especially when it gets a little bit darker. There's a lot of other cool stuff back here. You know how I'm a fan of grocery hooks in the back of cargo areas. Well, this not only has grocery hooks, but these are lockable hooks, or they're closed hooks. So you can hook your, I have my backpack hooked to there right now through the handle. So you can see how you can push them through, and then they'll close And what's nice about that, say you're going off-roading, you have a bunch of things in the back here, like your backpack, you don't want them to actually roll around. Well, that's gonna really secure them very, very well. So you have those on both sides. You also have a 12-volt outlet. You also have a 120-volt plug with a 400-watt inverter back here. So that should power most things that you have. Let's just take out my bag here. Okay, come closer here. The floor has a rubberized texture, and you can remove the whole floor if you choose to wash it. For instance, I did actually spill a little bit of a liquid here, so I could just take that out and wipe that down. And underneath here is a full-size spare tire. In behind the rear seats houses a new cargo system here. So we can pull that up and we can rest it here. And what's nice is there's magnetic enclosures. You can hear it snap close there. So now when we extend it out here, we can use this as a full second shelf. So you can separate your items here, or you can actually lock the system here. So let's just lock this and pull it out. And it's gonna go, lock. There we go. There it's latched, just like that. But check this out. There are two legs here. So we go and pull these legs out, extend them out, and down it comes. It supports more weight because it is supported on the bumper here. It'll support 13 kilograms or 30 pounds. What is this useful for? Well, you're tailgating, you want to put your food here, it's because it's nicely extended out, or maybe you're doing some work and, oh, I need to, oh, check out, oh, yeah, I need some gear here. Okay, and that's it. This is brilliant. What a great idea this is. And when you don't need it, you can just, let's just say, pull this back, fold those in, and you hear that nice positive lock from that magnetic closure there. And you can slide this back if you want. These are just the tip of the iceberg in terms of accessories that you can get for the Bronco Sport. There are over 100 factory supported accessories to make this Bronco Sport have even more utility. For instance, you can, of course, fold those seats down to have more cargo room, but you can get an interior bike rack, and this will house two 27.5-inch wheeled mountain bikes vertically, fit them in here. Of course, you gotta take the front wheel off, but other than that, they will fit in here, so you can go mountain biking with your buddy, your partner, everything, all your gear will fit in here. You don't even have to actually have the bikes sitting outside on a bike rack here or on top. You can leave that for other things, like maybe a tent on top, or, you know, basically, the sky's the limit of what you wanna gear up on this Bronco Sport. All right, so for the inside of the Bronco, well, right there, you have a bucking Bronco in front of you on the steering wheel. You also have those on the seat backs as well. And yeah, so this Badlands starts at about $40,000. And when you option it out, as you see here, it runs you about $45,000. These are Canadian prices, by the way. So this one is also equipped with the B&O sound system. You get the panoramic roof. But standard on all Bronco Sports, you have an 8-inch Sync 3 digital display system. You get Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. That comes standard with it. This has backup camera as well. What I love, it has a front view camera. So when you're doing some off-roading, you can select. You don't have to go through any menus. There's a dedicated button. So you just press that button. That's going to activate that camera for you. And the best of all, these cameras have washers on them. So when you're playing in the mud like I was, and they're all mucked up, when you use your wipers, it actually activates the camera. Also, by the way, interesting fact, these are auto-sensing wipers, but they're auto-sensing for the rear as well. I think that's the first time I've ever seen that. I like the front shelf just below the screen, and this one is also equipped with wireless charging. Now, this Bronco Sport, especially this Badlands edition, is built for adventure seekers. Whether you're a windsurfer, kayaker, snowmobiler, a mountain biker, camper, you know, You throw it all in here, you're gonna get messy, you're gonna get dirty. I've already gotten the actual floor mats very dirty, but underneath those, you don't have to worry. This has a rubberized kind of floor. So it doesn't look quite the best, you know, if you actually take the floor mats off, but man, oh man, is it ever easy to clean. You can basically almost hose it off. Also, the switch controls here are actual silicone sealed as well. I wouldn't recommend taking a hose and hosing everything off in here, but you know what? Some water in here, it's not gonna hurt it, and that's a really, really nice thing when you have a utility vehicle like this. Okay, I promised that we would get back here. Okay, a fair amount of room back here. Of course, I mentioned these seats do fold flat, but when you sit in here, you have a large cutout for your head from where the front goes to here. So almost unlimited amount of headroom, obviously not unlimited, but I would say at least if you were 6'2", you would still fit in the back here. So here are a couple different things here. This one is equipped, watch this. Ta-da! You have under seat storage, kind of a hidden compartment here. There is a latch on the lap area here, and it is a rubberized texture, so you can put say some wet items. That's what Ford says. One disappointing thing though, it's only on the passenger side and it stops right there. It would be nice if they extended this all the way for the full length of the rear seat. Perhaps you are going kayaking, you have your oars that you want to put under here or something. I don't know why it was just the one single seat. So but yeah, that is a nice option. This does not have a rear climate control. You do have vents here, but you do get another 110 volt electrical outlet with a 400 watt maximum inverter. The back of each seat on this Badlands, you have a zippered compartment. Check this out. Unzip there, a nice yellow finish, and it's kind of padded a little bit. It's protected, that's for sure. So you can put valuables or let's say your tablet in there. Close that up, out of sight, out of mind. And below that you have this loop system, so you can actually put things in between the loops like flashlights or any outdoor gear you have, or I've got my my ear pods connected to there. And then on the side bolsters even of each seat, there is a pocket here so you can put your phone. So the back seat passengers have so many options for innovative storage, and it's a really good use of the rear space here. All right, let's see how she drives. Put her into drive. This has a rotary dial for gear selector. Bronco Sports come standard with an 8-speed automatic transmission and two different power plants. There is a 1.5-liter EcoBoost engine that puts out 181 horsepower and 190 pound-feet of torque, which we have not driven that one because we have the Badlands, which gets you the 2-liter EcoBoost engine, and that gives you 245 horsepower and 275 pound-feet of torque. It'd be nice to try that smaller engine, because I'd say this 2-liter is adequate, but I think the 181 horsepower might be a little bit underpowered for this vehicle. But anyways, we'll have to try that out. All Bronco Sports come with all-wheel drive, unlike the Ford Escape, which is great. And of course, the Badlands gives you that off-road package. So we'll talk about the off-road in a second. Let's talk about the on-road characteristics of this. Really good suspension that does have independent rear suspension. They've really dialed it in for on-road performance, even though considering this is an off-road rugged styled vehicle. And yeah, so good steering feel. On center, it feels great. Good brakes. The transmission is fairly quick to respond, and overall it is a quite quiet ride in the cabin here, even over some of these really bumpy roads that we're going over. So I did have a chance to take it off-road, However, you know, we're not talking extreme off-road rock crawling, but definitely more than just logging roads. There is some pretty decent ground clearance on those Bronco Sport, so you'd have to go through some pretty rough stuff in order to actually come close to bottoming this out. So if you have to go through water, or you want to go through water, like in my case, the water wading distance or height is 23.6 inches, more than enough. You know, I'd say that for most people, the off-road capabilities of this Bronco Sport far exceeds of what your needs will ever be. If you are an adventure seeker, sure, you will take this off-road, but probably on some, you know, some gnarly logging roads, this will handle that, zero issue. You do have on this Badlands, you have a dual clutch locking rear. So there is a button here so you can lock up that rear if you need extra traction, so both wheels are turning at the same speed. So that is another option you have. Plus you also have trail control, which is like an off-road cruise control. You can just set that on. All you have to do is just steer. It's going to brake and it's going to operate the throttle for you. So nice when you're handling some gnarly stuff. But overall, like, I can just see, you know, going camping with this, going on, you know, extended long gravel roads or snowy roads, and this rear independent suspension is going to be just a delight for all passengers, including the driver. Just, it's just so much more comfortable, and it gives the driver so much more confidence, especially if you're going over like washboard type of roads. All right, we now have some passengers in the vehicle. We've been using this all week as a family vehicle as well. We've done lots of different activities. As we've mentioned, this is a great activity vehicle. We went up to the mountain. There was snow up there. We did some tubing. Of course, the all-wheel drive handled it just perfect. So, you know, I don't know if it's my old age getting old right now, but this Bronco or this type of utility just really works for what I think that it's meant for, and that is activities, families. Sure, I do like, you know, sports cars that go 0 to 60 in 2 seconds and premium ultra luxury vehicles. In fact, next week, tune in, I'm gonna be driving something that's got over 700 horsepower. But you know what, I have to commend Ford on this Bronco Sport, because they really have put the U in the SUV on this as for utility. It has lots of room in the cargo area, different cargo options available. You have technology, lots of creature comforts, as we mentioned, lots of accessories that you can make this Bronco Sport however you want it, to make it your own. And of course, you have off-road capability. Now, there will be the odd person out there that will need something more capable like the larger Bronco one, but I'm telling you, for the majority of people, this is all you need. This has more than enough off-road capability, actually more than I even expected. And yeah, so if you're looking for a utility that has all of that, definitely put this on your list. However, the only thing that this does not have, though, is it doesn't have a hybrid or PHEV option. If you want one of those, you're gonna have to go into the Ford Escape at this time. So anyways, I hope you enjoyed our outdoor adventure Bronco Sport review. We'll see you next time on Everyday Reviews. Make sure to like and subscribe. Take care.
Is it hard for you to
push? Does it go faster with more people or slower?
Faster.
Oh, great. Hey, wave, you guys. Look at Daddy.